printing has been around for several years now, specifically in the consumer space. 3D printing itself has been around since the mid-80s. Now, what is wild about 3D printing is it roared onto the scene. It became this popular, super cool new technology in the garage or in the consumer market because they were finally able to dial in the 3D printing process and make it affordable for people like you and me. Now, what is very, very interesting is in the past year or so, 3D printing, the popularity has been kind of dying off a little bit, or at least cooling off, to say the least. Why? Because some people are a little disillusioned that after they pay $1,000, $2,000 for a 3D printer, they realize all they're able to actually produce is something small and something that would basically you could go out and buy already, like toys or little models and things like that. And everybody's like, wow, is that really it? I thought this was a really cool technology, and it seems to be the only thing that I can produce is stuff that's basically already out there and a tremendous amount less expensive. So what's really cool about 3D printing is there is something amazing on the horizon, and I'm getting ready to fill you in. The revolution of 3D printing and what is going to be so disruptive, to use a buzzword out there right now, is the fact that you can rapid prototype. Well, everybody knows the fact that you can rapid prototype with 3D printing, but the first thing people do is they take this rapid prototyping and then they try to go to market with a product, which takes out the whole speed of the whole process. Well, there's something cool that I've been thinking about and doing a lot of research about, and that's the fact that 3D printing enables you to rapidly prototype what I call bridging materials, or materials that and products and pieces and brackets and things like that that can connect and make normal materials that are out there right now that are super cheap yet super strong, and then turn them into something super useful. For the first time, you're not just printing out plastic junk, you're now printing out and connecting cheaper materials to build really cool stuff. Notice I didn't say make. Not a big fan of the make thing. I think Martha Stewart makes greeting cards. I build cool stuff in my garage, so huge difference. I like to talk about building stuff, and that is where 3D printing is actually going. So, do you want some examples? I'll give them to you really quick. First of all, you've got wood. I've got some shelves behind me. As you can see, these shelves are super simple, and they're actually pre-cut from most hardware stores. You can go out and find pre-cut pieces of pine and super cheap shelves that are very, very inexpensive, $3 or $4 a piece at the most. Also, PVC pipe. PVC pipe is absolutely amazing, and people have actually been making cool stuff with it for years. But it never really could break through because the stuff that they were making, they were using the connectors that were already out there. And connectors for PVC pipe are simply to make longer and more complex shape out of pipe. They weren't connectors designed to make structures. And with 3D printing, now we can print out and create connections almost instantaneously, whatever angle, whatever shape, whatever we need to be able to connect this extremely cool material and do it very, very effectively. Why am I such a huge fan of PVC? Because it is cheap. It is super cheap and it is super, super strong. So you can now take PVC pipe of any size, create a connector for it, and build some amazing things. And that's where my Plexus project is, and that's why I developed Plexus, to show you this capability and show you what you can do and how easy it is and how customizable it is and how you can build something super, super useful. So 3D prototyping, where it's going to take us in the future, is actually a really exciting place. All of a sudden, you're going to see materials that you didn't really think much about, certainly not for a long time, that have become less and less expensive over the years, to finally make a tremendous resurgence onto the scene of the garage builder, because now you can build amazing things using materials that have always been around and have always been cheap, but now you can do it much more effectively and certainly much more creatively. So I hope you're as excited about this concept as I am, and I hope you stick around so I can show you some of the cool stuff that I've been working on, and it will blow your mind, I promise. So subscribe to my channel. I've got tons of videos coming because I have tons of ideas down this road, and I'm going to show you how to customize and make amazing stuff in your garage at home. And remember, we're not going to make it, we're going to build it, because we're going to build cool stuff. We're not just going to make green cards. All right, so hang on. It's going to be a wild ride. If you've got any questions, I'm easy to track down. CommandoDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.